We're standing in this incredible space that's hiding in plain sight. It has this kind of sense that the entire city has grown around it. It was built to accommodate this large influx of people they assumed would come to the Crystal Palace, and that never actually happened. Then it became a billiards hall, and then I think in the 60s it was closed, never really been open to full public use. This sort of pocket of time that's been preserved. People talk about that I came to sculpture through painting and architecture, but I also really came to it through film. Too, this idea of the edit, and that volume has been turned up in my work since film is so accessible. We're communicating at such an incredible speed. These images that are being traded all the time, that we're creating all the time, and it's just every day. So the work is very much about that. Every part of the piece is part of an image-making system that is trying to clock the space, that is trying to clock time, that is trying to create an experience of serendipity, of surprise. So the way that the film is structured is almost like a book. It's in chapters. In each chapter, there's anywhere from 3 to 6 moments that bleed into each other. So it's almost like shuffling cards. There's like one where you see lots of images at once, and then you see a fox running by, and then you see lots of images. And it's that feeling of you want it to come back, but you don't know when it's going to come back. But then you're already on to something else. So it plays in all these different ways that film creates anticipation. The back part of the piece I made last week. It's quite radical because it's a very different language back there, because it's so much to do with nature and landscape directly. It was this idea that you'd have this entirely unexpected experience in what one would normally consider the back of the piece is actually as relevant as the front. So the sculpture is making the film is making the sculpture. To me, there's painting, there's architecture, there's printmaking. Everything is actually deeply porous and deeply intertwined. And you're constantly shifting between what you're seeing and what it's becoming. It'll be different here when it's hot, it'll be different when it's cold. You know, it'll be different audiences in the evening than in the day. And so there's this evolution of how the piece can be alive. My job as an artist is to expand creative license. It's not about whether someone likes it or not. It's about questioning, it's about discovery, it's about having a moment in your life marked in time. For me, a great work always makes me go back into my life and understand it anew. I feel a shared sense of what it is to be human in a new way that I could never have felt before. So I think those are always major desires. I think, you know, you're creating ideally a conversation over time where you're passing a story about what it is to be alive to your audience and hopefully to many generations of audiences.